All right. Okay. No.
I'm Taylor.
This is my first YouTube video. And, you know, I was low-key, like, freaking out. But, you know, if you want to see this makeup look, then keep on watching and I will show you. Okay, so I already did my brows off camera. And after I do my brows, I usually do my eyes. So I'm going to prime them with the NYX HD Studio Photogenic Concealer. And I'm just gonna blend that out with my finger because, you know, I use a brush when you have one right here. Okay, now that my eyes are primed, now I'm going to go in with. Gonna go in with the Morphe 35O. See the beauty? The beauty? Beautifulness? Okay. And then for eyeshadow brushes, you know, kind of stick to like a couple main ones because falling on a budget. Anyways, I use the Wet n Wild. It's like the large eyeshadow brush. And then I also use the AOA Studio E101. It's kind of like a smaller, like, flat kabuki, like eye kabuki, you know? So we're going to go in with the Wet n Wild brush, and we're going to be taking, see this? This color right here for our transition shade, and put that right in the crease. Okay. That didn't do shit. That's okay. We're just going to go in with a different one. Okay, now we're going to go in with this right here. And add that to the crease as well. All right. Okay, now we have our crease color on. Now we're gonna go in with this color right here at the top. Like a orangey color. And we're gonna add that to like the outer part of the crease. Actually, screw it, just put it in your whole crease. Yeah, just do that. Got a nice transition set, you know? So next we're gonna go in with this one. Right here. It's like a cafe brown, like, you know, coffee with like not enough creamer in it. You know, my brush just fucking broke. Look. I'm gonna just super glue it because I'm gonna put this in my outer crease and I switch to the AOA E101 brush. Darken up the outer crease with this one and we're gonna make it a little bit darker. I'm gonna go back to the Wet n Wild brush and I'm just gonna blend the crease a little bit more and kind of soften up the edges up to the, like the brow bone. Next, we're just gonna do some liner. The matte liquid liner, a little wingy wingy, tingy tingy. We've got like a little baby wing, and I will do the other one off camera, and I will be back. All right, I finished the other eye, and now we are going to move on to the face. So before I do my face makeup, I always go in with my face moisturizer because I have really dry skin. And makeup don't fuck with dry skin, so just gonna apply this all over the face. That stuff is so good. Like, this bottle is so big. Like, this is my first bottle and it's lasted me like months. And I use it every morning, usually before my makeup, and then every night before I go to bed. And it's for sensitive skin too, so it doesn't break me out. You know, it doesn't bug me. And it just lasts for like ever. And it's cheap, so. You know. So on that low income. No money. Fucking make your coffee at home. Fucking budget. So, okay. And then I go in. Oops. Oh my gosh. I literally. Do you ever get like makeup on your hand? And you're like, where the fuck did that come from? I don't know. Okay. Then I'm going to be taking my Mario Badescu facial spray with aloe, herbs, and rose water. Spray that all over my face. And I'm going to let that dry a little bit. Now we're going to be taking the Maybelline Fit Me, the matte foundation, shade 220 Natural Beige. So just pour a little bit on the back of my hand. Or a lot of it. And then I take my PH Cosmetics brush 116. It's like a little kabuki brush. I use this for my foundation every day. Kabuki, kabuti. Same thing. Okay. And I'm just gonna dip on my hand and start. Just, if you're gonna cake it, go big or go home, honestly. Okay. That's too much. Oh, Taylor, you'd see. God. Okay. I just got it in my hair. Always go down the neck. Like, if you were a giraffe, you would want to blend it down your neck, you know? Because your neck, as a giraffe, is like part of your whole face. And you just have to do it, okay? Oh my god, this is taking like 4 years to blend out. See, look, it's wider than my forehead, but like the same color as my cheeks. Wait, my face cheeks or my... I'm done with my foundation. Now we're gonna go in with the same concealer that I used to prep my eyes. Here we go. And then I have my Real Techniques Miracle Complexion Sponge. I'm just gonna blend that out. And then I take my Maybelline Fit Me. It's a concealer, but I get it in shade 30, Cafe. Gonna blend that out, and now I'm going to bake slash set like under my eyes and where I crease with the Airspun translucent powder. And I put a lot in my smile line area because I'm just a happy person, okay? And I just like to smile. Okay, so we're gonna let that sit for a little bit, like 2 minutes. And we're gonna wipe it off. Okay, I let that sit for a quick minute, and now I'm gonna brush it off with this Eco Tools Kabuti brush. Kabuti. Okay, sorry. Not really feeling blush today. So now we're gonna go in like bronze slash extra contour. I'm gonna go in with the Naked Skin Shapeshifter by Urban Decay, and we're going in with the powder side, and we're using this shade right here, and this is a BH Cosmetics brush 114. It's like an angled kabuki. Into my Elvis Presley sideburns, you know, and I take a little bit on my forehead because like my forehead's huge, so yeah. And then I know this isn't like a small brush, but I don't like to contour my nose too much, so I kind of just, with this side, I just run it down the sides of my nose. A crazy nose contour on me looks like, makes me look psycho. So, next we're going to be taking the Morphe M510 brush. It looks like this. It's a nice highlighter brush, and we're going to be taking the Anastasia Beverly Hills Glow Kit in Sundipped. We're going to take Moonstone. cake on my nose. My nose is glowing. You want the cake on the cake, not on the plate, you know? And then we're gonna put it on the Cupid's bow. That's cute. That's cute. Cute, cute. Your lips look so pink. You know Monsters, Inc., when they get their lips, like, sucked? The little alien dude gets his lip sucked, and he's like... Okay, and then we're gonna take this. This is not a large eyeshadow brush. Ulta's on crack. But, this large eyeshadow brush from Ulta. We're gonna dip into Moonstone again, and we're gonna put that on our brow bone. And then to set the face, I use the Mario Badescu rose water again, and I'm just gonna spray that all over my face. And then to blend everything together and make it look like not so powdery, I take the Real Techniques Miracle Complexion Sponge again, and I just pat that all over my face. And for mascara, I'm gonna be taking the Voluminous Lash Paradise by L'Oreal, the pink one. And it's like the same color as a Better Than Sex. I feel bougie when I use it, even though it's not Better Than Sex. And I just use a regular blue lash curler. Curl my lashes. Now for these labials, my lips. Should have got organized before I did this. I'm going in with the NYX and just the regular like lip liner. In shade 810 Natural, and I'm gonna line my baby lips with them. And then, since my lips get really dry, I usually take my a chapstick and I. Should we do matte or should we do? Okay, we're gonna do the Rimmel London 640 Summer Angel. It's like a little nugget. A little nugget. And I'm gonna be taking this Beauty Rush lip gloss, Victoria's Secret, you know, OG, 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 boo boo. And then I'm just gonna tap that in the middle. That's it. Usually I put on like falsies or something, but I ain't going anywhere. And I ain't gonna waste a good ass falsie application night, okay? Okay. Call me Cardi. Just fucking kidding, don't ever call me Cardi. And like and subscribe. If you're my friend, subscribe. If you are watching this, then you're my friend. So subscribe if you like coffee. Subscribe if you like dogs. Subscribe if you like cookies. Subscribe if you like dill pickles. Subscribe if you like lemonade. Subscribe if you like people. Subscribe if you're obsessed with makeup. Subscribe. Yeah. Okay. Peace out.